This delicious recipe has been in my family for generations. My great-grandmother was often preparing this vegetable casserole out of necessity and creativity. This dish is not just a simple meal. It's a culinary journey back in time, filled with love and tradition. I will start by cleaning my vegetables. I am peeling two onions, give them a good rinse, and set them aside. Then I'm peeling a few potatoes and give them a good rinse. And I'm also peeling some carrots and set everything aside for later. I will clean some cassia peppers, but you can use bell peppers instead. Then peel two eggplants or zucchinis. We will also use a handful of green beans, some tomatoes, cabbage, and some rice. Now that we have everything prepared, it's time to put the casserole together. I will start by dicing half of the onions and sprinkle them on the bottom of a big pot. This is an old pot that doesn't look great, but it's doing the job every time. You can also use a tall tray for this recipe. Then I will slice my potatoes, and I will also cut some small potato pieces to fill everything. Layer the potato slices on top of the onions, and to cover all the spots, use the small potato pieces. I will repeat this until I layer all my potatoes. I will continue by slicing the eggplants. You can use zucchinis instead. Same as before, I will also cut some small pieces to fill all the gaps. I will layer the eggplant slices same as I did for the potatoes. And I will repeat until I finish all my eggplant slices. Sprinkle some salt, then slice your peppers, and add them in a layer over the eggplant. Cut the green beans in smaller pieces, and add those to the pot. Slice all the carrots diagonally, and add a layer. Dice the remaining onions and sprinkle them over the carrots. Then add some salt. Add the rice over the vegetables and try to distribute it evenly. Fine cut the cabbage. Add it to a bowl and rub it with salt until it softens. Then add a layer over the rice. This is our last layer, so slice your tomatoes and arrange them to cover well the cabbage. My great-grandmother also added a little chopped parsley on top, if you have some handy. When everything is set, add 2-3 tablespoons of sunflower oil. In a cup, mix some pepper and 1-2 tablespoons of salt with some water and pour over your casserole. Add 1-2 more cups of water, depending on your dish size and shape. We want the water to stay below the vegetables. Put the dish in the oven at medium to low heat for 2-2.5 hours. The dish is done when the edges of the tomatoes turn dark. Now that you saw how it's done, you can play with this recipe and add more vegetables, like sweet corn, peas, broccoli, or replace some ingredients, like using zucchini instead of eggplant. That's it! I hope you enjoyed my great-grandmother's recipe. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe to get our latest handmade and homemade news.